Saha Institute of Nuclear Physics Parichalaka Acharya Ajit Kumar Mohanty. Rajya Sabha mein mera saathi varishtha rajneta Shri Pradeep Bhattacharya ji. Friends from the faculty, my young researchers and sisters and brothers, I am indeed pleased to be with you all today in an institution that was founded by Professor Meghna Saha, great astrophysicist, visionary, science reformer of India and the founder director of this institute. I have gained immensely from the interaction with the faculty members and also the researchers, and have learned more about the work you are doing and the inspiration you derive from the founder's work. Professor Saha was the first person in the country to initiate the courses in nuclear physics in 1938. Following the discovery of nuclear fission in 1939, Professor Saha had foreseen an immense potential of nuclear physics in this country. See the vision, what he has foreseen at the time and what is happening now, how you people have made progress in this particular field. His visionary genius is evident in the reorganization of the physics syllabus of the university and plans to build a cyclotron. He accomplished this path-breaking task with a generous grant from Dorabji Tata Trust. It is truly remarkable that the construction of the cyclotron began in 1941, long before the foundation of the Department of Atomic Energy by the Government of India, which happened in 1954. After 1940, the rapid growth of nuclear physics in the world inspired, told Professor Saha, to propose an independent institute with close link to university. That is the genesis of this Institute of Nuclear Physics, was formed in 1949. Later, of course, is named after that great scientist, Saha Institute of Nuclear Physics, after the untimely death of Professor Saha in 1956. I am privileged to visit this historic institute, which was formerly inaugurated by Madame Renee Joliet Curie, a Nobel Prize winner and daughter of the famous scientist and Nobel laureate Marie Curie in January 11, 1950. I am glad to learn about the pioneering work done by Professor Saha. His introduction of innovative initiatives like the pre-PhD program, the first of its kind in the country to train MSc students for PhD, is truly impressive. It is really noteworthy that not only recently the UGC has realized the importance of such a bridging course and made it mandatory for all the universities. You have today given me an excellent glimpse into how young scientists are being encouraged by your institute to take up scientific research, and how this has been done over the last 67 years, with about 40 students being inducted into research and training program through a nationwide selection test. It is heartening that scientists are being mentored, and many of them are participating in the large international collaboration in CERN, Geneva. It is good to see that you are focusing on several outreach programs, and school and college level students are participating in debates, quiz, visit to the institute, laboratories, easy competition, and popular lectures. I noticed that you have not only confined yourself to merely urban areas and have conducted programs even in the remote areas of West Bengal. I am glad that the journey which started around the design and development of a small cyclotron initiated by Professor Saha has traversed a long path, and you are now setting up a facility for research in experimental nuclear astrophysics called as FRENA, F-R-E-N-A, which will unravel some more mysteries of the universe. Mysteries of the universe, that is the research being done. Whatever you may research and you may find, there will be something more to know about the universe. I must say that I am quite impressed by the range of programs taken up by the center, including an underground laboratory named, as just now director told, Jadugoda Underground Science Laboratory at the existing uranium mines in Jharkhand. My dear youngsters, researchers, I am filled with a sense of optimism for the future as I see about 15 young scientists with diverse skills and background joining hands for working on a novel multidisciplinary project related to cancer cells and therapeutic strategies. That's the need of the hour. Because as we are seeing, the cancer is spreading very wide, and thousands and lakhs of people are dying. And they are not able to diagnose this beforehand, and then they come to hospitals at a later stage. The Medicare is costly and also painful. So if early detection and also really narrowing it the place and then targeting it, isolating it and then trying to cure it, that will be very useful as far as the cancer disease is concerned. As a common man in a public life for more than 40 years, I have seen how the people suffer because of the sedentary lifestyle, tobacco chewing, change of lifestyle. That's the problem today. All of us have undergone a big change in our lifestyles. I think along with the research, along with the scientific development and also pharmaceutical advancement of the treatment and also getting the needed equipment, what is required is creating awareness among the people about the need for change of lifestyle and going back to our original way of living. And there has to be certain amount of physical activity, and we have to take care about the nature. We must love the nature and live with the nature, and then we must also revisit our food habits, because eating junk food, stored food, is causing many of the problems. Morning, I was there in Rafi Ahmad Kidwai Cancer Institute in Bangalore. Morning, I have inaugurated that building. I told the people there, in the presence of the Chief Minister, that there is a very need, urgent need, to revisit our lifestyles and go back to old system. Because while earlier our food was prepared, designed, and planned according to the seasons, according to the nature, now, with the advancement of so-called technology and advancement, we have changed our lifestyle, one. And secondly, we have also changed our food habits. Instant food, ready-made food, stored food, the end of it, that is also causing immense harm to the human body. Friends, today, when I see the research that's going on, particularly with this area of cancer, obesity, liver problems and other related problems, it is very much needed, because these are the areas, diabetic, liver, obesity, other cancer, these are the areas where the focus has to be more. And I am happy that here you are taking up that work. Your focus on encouraging young students to become scientists is a welcome initiative. The Vijnana Pratibha program launched by you on 31st July 2017 would undoubtedly train and motivate school students from class 8 onward to become scientists. All in all, my interaction with you today in this historic institute convinced me that there is so much that has been accomplished, and the grand tradition of learning, research, teaching and innovating will continue with renewed vigor and persistent passion. My good wishes to the director and the entire faculty, the researchers and the students who are keeping the light of learning burning bright. May your path be full of well-earned success, and if at all there are any failures, they are bound to be in any endure. I do hope you will take them as stepping stones for leaping higher. My dear friends, science, research is in search of betterment of the life of the people. The very purpose of science, the research, is how to make the people life better, how to make the people happy and comfortable. If you are comfortable, then you'll be really happy, and then life will be happy for you. Otherwise, if you are suffering from any of these ailments, then there are a lot of problems. So basically, science and research is for the betterment of the lives of the people. So many schemes we are bringing in. I was minister till recently, the smart city program, the Amrit program, the housing for all program, a lot of other programs are all being taken up. But the research and the scientific advancement and the new innovations and new technology, nanotechnology, all these things are really going to help us further to actually go into the root cause of the diseases, of the problems, of the changes that are happening in the nature, and particularly the biggest challenge we are facing, the climate change, and also the threat of nuclear. With all this in mind, I think there is so much need to focus more on science, and people should not only study science, they should also develop scientific temper, knowledge, and understanding, and apply it to the real life of the people. Friends, I am not an expert, I am not a scientist, I am not a researcher, I have been in public life for 40 years. What all I have understood is that three segments of the society are doing a yeoman service to the country. Three of them, as recognized by the country and by our leader, are Jai Jawan, who are protecting your frontiers, providing you security, Vijnan, Jai Jawan, Jai Vijnan, providing you the scientific knowledge for betterment of your life, and then Jai Kisan, producing food, taking care of your hunger, and making your life comfortable. All these three segments of the people who are doing a great job, Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, Jai Vijnan, should not remain only for a slogan. That should be respected, they should be recognized, and they should be encouraged. Any disrespect, ignoring, or denigrating, any of the three, as I said, the Jawans, the Kisans, and the Vijnans, that will be against the national interest. So anybody in public life who makes statement, who makes speeches, they should remember that utterances by them, any utterance of any kind against these three is not in the national interest. I hope you understand why I am saying this. And these three segments has to be encouraged, and we need to promote science further for the betterment of life, because as we have played with the nature, now we are facing the nature's fury. And the entire world now has to think about climate change and then come out with so many things because it has been long neglected. So what I suggest is nature, culture, combine for better future. That will be very much useful for the betterment of the human lives. And as I told you, my visit today is not to give lecture to you people. As I told you, I am not an expert, but my visit is in pursuance of my desire after becoming vice president to visit the various research and development institutes across the country, visit various universities, visit various IITs, IIITs, IIMs, and other technology research institutes, and also interact with the farming community to know better what is happening, what are the new advancements, and what are the problems, if any, and then use that input for the betterment of the public discourse and policy making in the country. As a vice president, you know that I have a protocol to follow. I don't get into other issues. I am no more in politics. I have retired from politics, but not tired from public life. I am equally interested in the betterment of the society, in making the country strong, stable and prosperous, and in making people happy, and in moving the country towards a new India where there is no fear, where there is no exploitation, where there is no corruption, where there is no atrocity, and where there is no hunger. That is the wish of all of us. After independence, we all thought the Swarajya, Surajya mein badal jayega. That is yet to be fully fulfilled. We have made so much advance, undoubtedly. We have made progress, but we have not made enough progress as per our original inherent strength. Because I feel Indian people, they have an inherent knowledge, wisdom. You look at the history. People from, students from across the world, globe, they used to come to India and study in Nalanda and the then Takshashila. Pahian, Hyunsong, Chinese historians came to India, wrote about the greatness and civilization of India. Not only that, even Varaha Mihira in the astronomy, you have Susruta in the medicine and surgery, you have Aryabhatta, you have Bhaskaracharya, you have so many examples like that. In those days, they made pioneering efforts and they have shown light to us. So that being the case of our background, this land is fertile, our brains are fertile. What is required is little more encouragement and little more skill upgradation. That is happening in the country. It should be accelerated, both the central government, state government, various institutions, including private people also should encourage. Morning, and I was there in the Cancer Institute of Kidwai in Bangalore, I found to my happiness that Infosys had contributed 100 crores. Satya Sai Institute is taking one aspect of it. There are a lot of other organizations of Bangalore, they have all come together. Same thing should happen to encourage research, to encourage development. Society also should participate, because the core philosophy of India is share and care. Share and care. Care about the society, not only about yourself. Sarve jana sukhino bhavantu. The entire universe should be happy. Vasudhaika kutumbam. The entire universe should live as one family. We may be different by languages, different by our habits, different by religions, but at the same time, we should all remember we are one nation, one people, one country. Vividata me ekata bharat ka visheshata. Alag bhasha, alag vesh, phir bhi apna ek desh. Irrespective of caste, creed, sex, region and region, India is one. And at the same time, entire universe also is one. That is our philosophy. If you go through history, India has no history of attacking anybody, in spite of such a knowledge. And for information, my youngsters, the India's wealth was 27% of the world wealth before invasions. 27% of the entire world wealth was in India. And now we are struggling to reach 7.4 and then double digit, and we are all working hard. So keeping that mind, we should all work towards reaching to that glory, and that is possible with the advancement of science and technology. As I told you, I came to see, learn. I am also of the firm opinion that everybody throughout their life should learn, including politicians. Learn, 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 not yearn, yearn, yearn. I am not saying nobody should yearn, but learn more. And I also advise the researchers who are getting research here, after studies, if you want to go abroad, I have no problem, go. But please remember three things. Go, learn further, yearn further, and return. Go, learn, yearn, and return, because at the end of the day, you have to help your motherland, your fellow people. Patriotism, Desha Bhakti, means not slogan, not putting garland to the photo frame of Bharata Mata, or not simply saying Vande Mataram. That means all the people in this country, they must all feel happy, they must all feel prosperous, and you should feel their pain. Treat it as your pain. That is the way forward, that all of us work together to make India strong, stable. And once again, I convey my compliments to all the faculty members here, and also convey my best wishes to the young researchers who are doing a good job here. And thank you very much for providing me this opportunity. I have gone around the campus, visited some of the labs, interacted with some of the scientists and other people who are working there, and I try to improve my knowledge. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.